On the 29th of October, 2022, 24-year-old Levi Davis was captured on CCTV, exiting the Old Irish pub in Barcelona, Spain. He had only travelled to Barcelona hours earlier after abruptly leaving a friend's apartment on the island of Ibiza. Levi was said to have been in good spirits, according to his mother Julie, who had been in frequent contact with him on that autumn day in October. And just prior to him being captured on CCTV, he had reached out to ask if his mum could lend him some money, as he needed to stay in a hotel within the area before continuing his journey across Europe.
"I can't help out this time, Levi. Sorry, you'll have to sort it yourself. No worries, mum. Thought I'd ask, but I'll sort it."
It isn't thought that Barcelona was his next destination to stay for a while, rather a stepping stone, but it isn't clear where he was to travel to next. After leaving out from the Old Irish pub, Levi was captured on CCTV once again, about a 10-minute walk away. He had passed by the Hard Rock Cafe, which would match up with the way he was walking after leaving. That CCTV footage is yet to be released to the public and would be the last confirmed sighting. In the early hours of October 30th, 2022, Levi's phone signal was last detected close to Barcelona Sant Estació mainline train station, and that was the last trace of him. Ladies and gentlemen, as of February 2023, Levi has still yet to be located, although as I'm recording this video, a breakthrough in the case has emerged, and Levi could in fact still be alive. Come with me as we take a deep dive into the case and take a look at various theories as to what could have happened. Levi Davis had made a decent name for himself in both the sports and entertainment world. At the age of 19, he had found himself making a debut for Bath Rugby Club in Premiership Rugby. That would be the elite level, similar to the Premier League in football for anyone who is unaware. He had also came fifth place with his group TriStar on the celebrity special edition of X Factor. This led him to start a modest music career. He had released his debut single, With Me, under the alias Ledder on September 14th, 2022. More music was due to be released. Although he had played rugby at the highest level, he only appeared 8 times for Bath in the 3 years leading up to 2020, and so he decided a loan move to Ealing Trailfinders would be the best, before signing for the club permanently on a 2-year contract soon after. Levi would end up signing for Worthing Rugby Club a year into his 2-year tenure, his last team. They currently sit in the 4th tier of the rugby pyramid, similar to the likes of League 2. Although he wasn't a Premiership rugby player anymore, to even brush shoulders with players in the league is an achievement in itself. He still earned a healthy salary, but that was all due to change in the summer of 2022. You see, Levi had suffered a knee injury which looked to threaten his rugby career moving forward. He was left without a club, and this led to a serious state of depression. Not knowing what the future would hold and whether he would even make a return to the sport, he decided to hop on a flight to Ibiza to visit a friend and work on his music career while recovering. From what we know of his time in Ibiza is that he met Richard Squire, a friend, and that he took some modelling snaps for his upcoming single, Los Angeles, which was due to be released in November of 2022. Photographer friend Aditokombu Aditona had this to say. "We took the pictures on the 20th of October. Levi invited me to take them for him for his upcoming single. I met him when he released his first single because I took the press pictures for it. We became friends and he asked me to come and do this shoot. Knowing these might be the last photos taken of him before he went missing is terrible. It is traumatic. He seemed positive about the future. He was learning to become a DJ and speak Spanish." On the 29th of October, 2022, Richard told reporters that out of nowhere, Levi told him he was going to visit some friends in Barcelona, but didn't go into specifics. He left without any spare clothes, had about 40 euros on him, and carried a small backpack. Over the last 3 months, the Spanish police have been investigating Levi's mysterious disappearance, but with a huge language barrier between them and Levi's family, the family decided to take it upon themselves to hire private investigator Gavin Burrows, who as of February 10th, 2023, made some huge developments that even the Spanish police were unaware of. Let's catch you up with everything we know so far. During the early days of the investigation, Levi's mobile phone activity was tracked. It's believed that Levi made contact with university friend Mike Guider. Mike said that at around 11:04 p.m., Levi had left him a voicemail message saying he couldn't wait for him to get over to Spain and see him. Meaning then, although he wasn't going to stay in Spain for long, he was at least going to stick around long enough for Mike to arrive. We now know then that an hour after he left the old Irish pub, he was still walking the streets of Barcelona. On the third week of the investigation, police were tipped off about two sightings close by to the old Irish pub. But so far, there have been no updates into those leads, meaning they could be dead ends. But there was a small breakthrough in the case 2 days after that call. On a quick side note, the calls and this breakthrough aren't connected. On the 19th of November 2022, Levi's passport had been located in Barcelona's port area by a cargo shipment, but it isn't clear if Levi had dropped this departing from the ferry as he stepped foot in Barcelona. In early December of 2022, Gavin Burrows had been called upon by the family to investigate the matter, as you're aware, and offered a £10,000 reward for information that could lead to Levi being located. During the first few weeks of his investigation, he revealed a few theories as to what may have happened to him, which we'll get into in just a moment. But first, let's take you through what he discovered earlier on this month, as this may point to the strongest theory that is currently being put forward. It all started when information was gathered that after Levi's disappearance, 38 contacts had been deleted from his Instagram account. I'll be reaching out to Instagram to provide legal explanation from which could be admissible in court. What we want to know is where it was accessed from. We need them to provide the location. The thing was though, someone else did have access to Levi's account that was known to him, more than likely a manager or a rep. But the thing was, they told Gavin that they hadn't been on his Instagram account in quite a while. 2 days after reaching out to Meta, Gavin was handed intel, more than likely from Instagram assisting in the investigation. What you're about to see is an Instagram post that was deleted minutes after it was uploaded, and this took place 2 days before Levi I went missing.
Hello. My name is Levi Davis and my life is in danger. This is a call to my friends from school, university, and my colleagues in rugby. This is a story about police corruption and government corruption, and also organized crime. I ask, no, I beg that you share, but that you listen and try to understand what I'm telling you. This all began in London. After the X Factor, I had many new friends and many old. It started when I was speaking with a friend, what I would now call an acquaintance. It is important for you to know that I am an impersonable guy. I believe I am humble, and I will speak to anybody. I didn't used to have a guard up, but for reasons why I'm about to tell you, I have not been myself for a very long time. 3 years ago, I came off the Celebrity X Factor, and I met many new people, and one of which, an individual who I will not name, we began a relationship which formed, a friendship which formed, was formed through music. Many times we had met, but on the last occasion, I was drugged and I was blackmailed. After this, I appealed to my club for help. I appealed to my agent for advice. I do not blame this on anybody, as we are all an aggregate of our own decisions. However, the response I got was one which my agent advised it would be best to resign, as he believed the club were going to fire me. After I asked them for help, after I believed I was being filmed doing sexual acts, after I was drugged, which many would call rape, and by law, we would call rape. After this, and the lack of support, I was not myself. I was searching for belonging. I was searching for help. I went to the police and I asked them if they could help me. I did not understand the full picture at that time. All I knew is something was happening to me, and it was not something good. On many occasions, I went to my family and my friends, who also did not understand what was going on. They pleaded with me to find evidence, which I went on a mission to try and find. Many a night was spent wandering the streets of London, wandering the streets of Birmingham. You may ask, why would you not just stay away from individuals which wish you harm? And that was what I tried to do by starting a new life in Australia. But what happened was that I was followed there also. What I wish you to understand is, with organized crime, it is not one person. It's an aggregate of people. People that you do not know. People that get into your lives through whatever means possible. In Australia, I had many, many a good memory. Because after I was hooked on drugs, and after I believe what I believe to be, have been filmed on the dark web, and videos of me in compromising positions, and the blackmail that followed me. After that, I came back because I realized that the only way through this was by understanding the full picture myself. This was then followed after I went back to one of these people to conform to their demands. I was told by them in ways in which are not direct, but are absolutely true, that they were going to attempt, if I said anything else, they were going to attempt to kill me, threaten my family, and they also were trying to frame me, and are. This was followed by many attempts of gaslighting, threats, and I've had enough. So I'm here to appeal to you to share this. The information that I gave to the police went directly back to these individuals. And I understand that the police are good people. It's full of good people trying to do their job. But there is also a fact that there is a large amount of police corruption. And the only way that these people would have had access to my private interviews with the police is through it being leaked. They also, to my knowledge, had access to my medical records, as they have reiterated things that only I have had conversations with the NHS. I was gaslit into thinking that I had psychosis, when many of the things I said are actually true. I believe this because I was looking for an understanding in which a puzzle I could not put together. My family, my friends, I thank you for being there, even when you didn't understand what was wrong with me. But I am now not safe. By doing this, I am not safe. I try not to put individuals' names in this, and I try not to be as vague as possible through fear of retaliation. However, it is, I understand that I am not the only one this is happening to, and that this has happened to. They openly said to me that they will try and frame me with the videos that they have of me and with the individuals that they have inserted into my life, some of which I'm sure I'm still yet to find out they are involved in this. They seek to undermine me. They seek to make me look like I am paranoid, like I am crazy. That is why I have that diagnosis of drug-induced psychosis. This is me taking my power back. I understand that they have videos of me, hence why my OnlyFans makes sense to me. Many years ago, I would not have done this. But I am sofa surfing. Through the amazing network of friends I have, I am so fortunate and I'm so thankful to the Samaritans for my rehab in Canberra, Australia. And also to Men's Link for counselling me and allowing me to see this for what it is. I do believe that this is a lot bigger problem than just me. Hence why I risk my life to do this. Now, after this, they will throw everything they have to make me look and shape me into a corner, and for a while I was conforming because there was no way out, conforming to try and understand their demands. In a corner, I was riddled with confusion, which is their intention. A metaphor for this would be being in a corner in the fetal position. That's what I was, scared. On the surface, I had to look normal. They told me to look normal. Videos in which they could get money from me. On the black market. On the black web. I don't know. Dark web. Whatever you want to call it. I'm no expert. But I do know what happened. Shaping me into positions in films. Shaping me in role play. All in the name of companionship. But these are not my companions. These are not my friends. Although they shape as them. But as a man of God, he did not give me a spirit of fear. He gave me a spirit of hope. And that is why I am posting this today. I hope that as my friends, you can share this and ignite it for what it is. They told me and they tell me that they have links to journalists. We don't know, I do not know how high this corruption goes. Are the stories they tell me true? Or is it something to scare me, to conform? I do not know. But they did say that they have links to a government minister. Think about that for a second. They've infiltrated my family. Members of my family, they've threatened my little sisters and brothers. And so I can't stand back here. And I won't. I just thank all the people that have come to me in my times of need. Because without you, I might not still be here. I remember vividly standing on the side of a bridge and my friend helping me off it. That's where this brought me to. The dark place that this brought me to.
After initial reports circulated that Levi may have drowned after his passport was located at Barcelona's port, Gavin Burrow's investigation suggested he may still be alive, and that's the strongest of the current theories. Gavin approached the news on the 10th of February 2023 to state that he believes that Levi was drugged, groomed, and manipulated over several months by a key suspect, who they know but haven't named just yet. Gavin said his team had a digital recording of said suspect admitting to putting Levi's picture on a dating website and accessing his social media accounts as recently as 3 weeks ago from when I'm recording this video. But it's unclear if this person is responsible for deleting the followers. In regards to this theory, that's all that's currently available, and Gavin hopes that even though Levi was lured to Barcelona, he's found alive. On the 9th of February 2023, after that most recent update, Gavin named Levi's friend as a person of interest who needs to be immediately arrested by Spanish authorities. It's unclear whether the new unnamed suspect is Levi's friend, but what he did say of him is that although he initially appeared to be assisting in the investigation, he'd actually been hindering it, and believed he may have something to do with his disappearance. The friend wasn't named. Another theory that circulated is that Levi had been kidnapped and forced to work as a courier, or worse, murdered after being in debt to Somali criminals. Reports say he owed roughly £100,000 to a, quote, Somali mafia. To back this original theory put forward by Gavin, it would be that Levi had allegedly fled his home in the United Kingdom and located elsewhere because of this debt. He believed that he was in danger. Again, this isn't the reason why he went to Spain. Rather, this had been ongoing over the past couple of years. We don't know what has happened to Levi, but we can only hope that he is alive and hopefully he'll return home safe.
Please, appreciate you. I appreciate you, sis. Honestly, I really do. And I love you guys. Seriously, I love you. And yeah, it's tough. But you know me. I'm a fighter. You know me, I'm a fighter, and that's what I'm gonna do. Thanks for getting in touch. I really, really, really do appreciate when you guys get in touch. And I'm really sorry. I've always been awful, but especially over this last period, it's been really hard keeping in contact. But no, big love, and I'll catch you guys soon, 100%.